Assalamu alaikum, students of class 10. I am Munazza Kareem and today we are going to discuss direct and indirect speech. Today we will try to discuss what is direct speech and what is indirect speech, why there is need to convert direct speech into indirect speech. We will also try to learn the difference between the structures of these two speeches. We will also learn the steps involved in the conversion. In the end, we will practice the sentences given in your grammar book. What is direct speech? The reporting of speech by repeating the actual words of a speaker, for example, he said, I'm going. If you report the same exact words as it is to a second person, to a third person, to someone else at some time later, this is called direct speech. What is indirect speech? Indirect or reported speech. Later on, the exact message is reported to a third person in a simplified way. For example, he said that he was going. Reporting speech is mostly used in reportings, in news reporting. Reporting speech is used if they are reporting about the speech of the Prime Minister or speech of a politician, they will use indirect speech to make a news. On the other hand, direct speech is mostly used in quoting from the holy books, from the famous speeches, or from the famous sayings of the famous people.
Let's look at the structure of the direct speech. Look at the first sentence. Mother said, comma, quote, I am busy at the moment, unquote. So all direct sentences have the similar kind of a structure. Every direct sentence has two parts, reporting speech and reported speech. Mother said is reporting speech. It's reporting that what has happened. Mother said it's reporting speech. I'm busy at the moment is a reported speech. And it's always separated by a comma and enclosed by inverted commas. The first letter of a reported speech is always capital.
Look at the structure of the direct speech. Direct speech has two parts. One part is inside the inverted commas. We call them inverted commas. These are inverted commas, or we call them quotation marks. The words written within the inverted commas are called reported speech. There is another part which is outside these inverted commas, which is separated by a comma. It is called reporting speech. So, a direct sentence has two parts, reporting speech separated by a comma, then a reported speech under the quotation marks. So, in this session, we are going to discuss assertive sentences. We are going to convert assertive sentences into indirect speech. So, just have a look what are assertive sentences. Most of the sentences of English language are assertive sentences. The sentence which declares or asserts a statement, feeling, opinion, incident, event, history, or anything is called an assertive sentence. An assertive sentence ends with a period. Ends with a period, it means that it ends with a full stop. An assertive sentence can both be a positive or negative sentence. So, in this session today, we are going to convert assertive sentences into indirect speech.
Dear students, let's closely study the direct and indirect speech. Compare how many changes have taken place while converting a direct sentence into indirect sentence. Look at sentence number one. Mother said, I'm busy at the moment. It's indirect version. Mother said that she was busy at the moment. Number one change that you can notice is the removal of inverted comma. Look at the sentence, please. There are no inverted commas on an indirect sentence. Then the use of that has been made. That has been used to join the reporting and reported speech. Then you can see that the capital I has been replaced with she. She that has a smaller s in it. And there is a change in tense as well. At the moment has been changed into at that moment. And we consider it other changes. So several changes have taken place while converting a direct sentence into indirect sentence. Now, the question arises, why there is need for this conversion? Why can't we express ourselves using only direct speech? There are two reasons. Number one is reporting speech and reported speech again and again. If you repeat, mother said, he said, she said, it doesn't sound good. Number one. Number two, it's not very simple because it involves the use of punctuation. So it's easier to convert this sentence into indirect speech without changing the meaning of the sentence. And why there is need to learn certain steps to change direct sentence into indirect sentence is to avoid any mistake in it. Look at the second sentence. Mother said, I was busy at that moment. Its indirect form is, mother said that she had been busy at that moment. So if you report that sentence, let's assume that you report that sentence to somebody else and you said that, mother said, I was busy at that moment. Instead, you convert it into indirect way, roughly, without following any rules. And you said, mother said, I was busy at that moment. The other person will take an impression that it's you who were busy, not your mother. So that's why the important use, correct use of pronoun is very important. Similarly, the correct use of tense is very important to convey the correct message, to convey the correct meaning. So there are several changes taken place. We will discuss these changes one by one. In the next session, we will inshallah cover the change of tense. Right now, we will pay attention to the change of pronoun. Dear students, in the previous slide, I've shown you the steps involved in the conversion of direct speech into indirect speech. Let's recap it. Number one, removal of inverted commas. Number two, capital letter of the first word of the reported speech is changed accordingly. Use of that, change of pronoun, and other changes. In the next session, we will cover the last two steps, that is, change of tense and other changes. At the moment, I want you to focus on change of pronoun. In this session, we will learn how to change pronoun of the reported speech, and we will practice it in the end. Change of pronoun. Look at the sentence. My mother says I'm busy at the moment. I here is a pronoun. What is a pronoun? Pronoun is a word that is used instead of a noun. So I here is a pronoun, and if we convey it like this, mother says that I'm busy at the moment, the wrong meaning will be conveyed. So instead, we should say, mother says that she is busy at the moment. So how to change this pronoun? Where to put which pronoun? I hope that you have learned the different kinds of pronoun in your previous classes. Look at the sentence. There are different parts of a sentence. Mother says to me, I'm busy at the moment. Mother in this part is subject. Me is object. And mother says to me is a reporting speech. We have just learned that it is a reporting speech. I'm busy at the moment is reported speech. And this is enclosed in inverted commas. I is the pronoun here. So topic in hand is change of pronoun. So how to change this I appropriately so that it conveys the correct message, the correct meaning is conveyed. One, two, three, they represent three kinds of pronoun: first person pronoun, second person pronoun, and third person pronoun. And S and O represent subject of the reporting speech and object of the reporting speech respectively. N stands for no change. So I've devised this simpler kind of a rule that you write down S, then O, then N, and on top of S write 1, on top of O write 2, on top of 3 write 3. So it means that first person pronoun changes with the subject of the reporting speech. Second person pronoun changes with the object of the reporting speech. And third person pronoun will not change. So first person pronouns are I, we, us, our, etc. Second person pronoun is you, your, etc. Third person pronoun is he, she, it, they, their, them, her, etc. So this will be the rule to change all these pronouns. Look at the sentences. You can see that the sentence is more or less similar. So what is being changed is the pronoun. In the first sentence, mother says, I'm busy at the moment. So we have just learned that first person pronoun changes with the subject of the reporting speech. And the subject of the reporting speech here is mother. So we substitute it with mother and we use third person pronoun for mother. So instead of I, we will use she. Mother says that she is busy at the moment. So how many changes have taken place? Which we removed the inverted commas, we added that, we used she instead of I, and capital letter is used accordingly, has been there was I in capital letter, but in she we didn't use capital S because we don't use capital S for she when it's in the middle of a sentence. Number two sentence, mother says to me, you are busy at the moment. Mother says to me, you are busy at the moment. And it's a second person, you is a second person, and it changes with the object of the reporting speech. And object of the reporting speech is me. So mother says that to me, I am busy at the moment. See, second person changes with the object of the reporting speech. Here object is me, so we change it into its subjective case. Me is an objective case. We change it into objective case of me, which is I. Look at the third sentence. Mother says she's busy at the moment. Mother says that she is busy at the moment. Have you noticed that there is no change in the pronoun, and we have just learned that third person pronouns are not changed. There is no change in third person pronoun when we convert a direct sentence into indirect sentence. So students, here we move towards the end of our lesson. I hope that you have learned the steps and you will practice it. And after practicing, I would recommend you to solve the exercise given in your grammar book, and then match your answers with the answers given here in the last two slides. Dear students, I will join you very soon with more videos covering direct and indirect speech. Till then, Allah Hafiz.